Reopening of schools after a closure requires many considerations, but if done well by the school administrators, teachers and staff, it can promote students' health and well-being. The pandemic situation has developed certain challenges to school education. Some of these challenges are mentioned here. The first and foremost is creating awareness and caring about COVID-19 among the students and teachers. Another is prioritizing health, well-being and sanitization in the school children. Next is maintaining social distancing and creating stress-free learning environment. In this hour of crisis, every stakeholders need to rise to occasion to shoulder the responsibility of ensuring a safe environment in the school, so that no one gets infected by the virus. In the recent years, the focus of learning has shifted from mere acquisition of knowledge to development of competencies and skills. To this end, NCERT has developed competency-based learning outcomes in various subjects across different grades. Pedagogical processes to be adopted in the class for developing these competencies have also been elaborated. With learning outcomes in focus, the teaching learning processes during COVID period may focus on the following things. The first is during first week, formal teaching learning may not take place. Rather, the first week may be devoted to acclimatize students about that new practices that they are expected to follow, their mental preparation. Effort should be made towards awareness generation, practicing safety, exercises, mock drills, etc. A sense of confidence needs to be enthused among the students as well as parents. Ask open questions about their activities during closure of the school, what precautions they and their family took, etc. And listen them. Be honest. Explain the truth in a child-friendly way. Show them how to protect themselves and their friends. The schools may prepare in advance a comprehensive staggered plan or calendar for the academic year, taking into account effective hours of teaching in school and self-study at home. While preparing a curriculum plan or academic calendar, weightage needs to be given to psychological well-being of students in pandemic environment. The alternative academic calendar prepared by NCERT can be suitably adopted in accordance with the local situations and existing conditions. Create awareness about COVID-19 by discussing myths, social stigma and fear among the students in a classroom in a friendly manner. Children may be asked to take a pledge focusing on do's and don'ts. Time may be allocated during the school schedule to daily reflect on it. Interesting activities such as drawing and painting of his or her own interest, storytelling, writing, reading a chapter and developing summary points, numerical and sums on the concept already explained well in the school, audio and video recording using mobile and camera of various elements of nature, preparing some food items such as sprouts, salad, which does not require heating, etc., student can do on their own. Creating learning resource bank by making listing e-material, television programs and radio programs locally available, as well as electronic devices available with the students for learning, is another measure which can be explored for facilitating teaching and learning process. Some micro yogic exercises like the rotation of the head, shoulder, feet, stretching, etc. for primary students, and some simple asanas like Tadasana, Rukshasana, Swastikasana, Vajrasana and other breathing practices like Kapalbhati, Anulom Vilom also can be organized for students in upper primary classes. Introduction of regular meditation practices in schools may also contribute in well-being as well as improvement in learning outcome of students. The alternate day school scheme envisages that during the period of pandemic, learning of students will comprise of face-to-face teaching in school and self-study at home. Under the school system of education, students learn under controlled environment. The child remains under guidance and supervision of teacher during the entire duration of the day and semester or a year, whereas in alternate day school model, the student has entire freedom of doing self-study in selecting and creating environment on his own. Making the alternate day school model workable is a new emerging challenge to educators, teachers and parents. The main challenge is to create awareness among the students on clarity and purpose of the alternate day school model. The next challenge is to motivate the students on effectiveness of self-study, to develop resilience in students on facing pandemic environment, and to train students in time management skills for better organizing themselves and utilizing their time in productive way. Schools in urban areas with high-speed internet may focus on e-learning and using video conferencing platform like Google Hangout, Microsoft Teams, etc. for conducting classes. In rural areas, the Diksha platform, which already connects many states, may be utilized for teaching. In addition to other digital platforms such as NROER, ePathshala, etc., the students, teacher, principals and administrators need to shed fears, if any, of using technology and start incrementally using the same. Teachers may be encouraged and trained to prepare lessons plan in regional languages and put them on YouTube. The school and teacher also need to focus the most vulnerable students, like homeless students, migrated students, students with disabilities, and students directly affected by COVID-19, maybe through death in the family, relation or hospitalization. Such a student requires special attention. The formal and summative assessment of students' learning using paper pencil may not be insisted for the time being. Rather, the focus should be on employing non-formal methods of assessment. Some of the negative emotions experienced by all, including students and teachers, like anxiety, worry, fear, is normal. However, it is important to be mindful to the well-being of students and to help them to cope up with their stress and anxiety. In addition to safety, for holistic development of students, we also need to ensure that children live in a stress-free environment. Thank you.